Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Miss Nude America contest, coming to you live for the first time on national television. We have 50 gorgeous gals for you, each one totally and completely naked. And it's for this reason that the Federal Communications Commission is making us issue this warning. The following program may contain material which may be objectionable to some of our viewers. So now let's get on with the show and meet our 50 Miss Nude America contestants, each one totally nude, completely naked as jaybirds, nude as the day they were born. And sometimes I wonder, where do they keep their spare change? But we're going to find out that about them and a heck of a lot more. Without further ado, let's welcome Miss Nude Alabama!
We interrupt this program to bring you this special announcement. It's time for Laugh Tracks.
Okay, we're friends. We can be honest. I'll be honest. I've used the ladies' room.
Yeah, and I've used the men's room.
Me too. I guess we're all alike in that
respect. We're all alike in that respect.
Now, we're being honest, right? Now, we've all thought of somebody else when we're making love, right?
Yes, I thought of Annette. What's her name?
Me too.
You too?
Me too.
Steve Garvey.
We're all alike in that respect.
We're all alike. And listen, we're being honest, right? We're being honest. Yeah. We've all put on our girlfriend's underwear and danced in front of the window.
Welcome to Laugh Tracks, hosted by Jim Stahl. Howie Mandel, Gail Mathias, Lucy Webb, and featuring Frank Welker, with guest stars Fred Willard, Cool and the Gang, and Billy Idol. Laugh Tracks is brought to you by Clairol Condition Shampoo and Clairol Condition 2, the beauty prescription for your hair.
Hello, I'm Jim Stahl, and this is my L.A. at night. You know, a lot of television shows will show you a nighttime scene like this, but it really won't be night at all. They use a technique called day-for-night shooting. They'll actually shoot the nighttime scene during the day, and then they use a filter and special lighting techniques and make it look like it's a nighttime scene. In other words, they've lied to you. But we here on Laugh Tracks feel that next to comedy, honesty is our most important product. And to prove that, I am going to respond to these letters that you people have written into the show. Now, a lot of shows, they'll read the letters just to make a joke, just to be funny. But we're not going to do that in Laugh Tracks, no. I'm going to be honest about these questions. Here's the first letter. Dear Jim, have you ever cheated on your wife? Okay, it's a good question. But it's worded a little bit vaguely. I don't know whether you mean cheated at cards or parcheesi or sexually or what. I'd like to answer this, but I really can't do it at this time. I'm sorry, it's a little confusing. Let's go to the second letter. See if we do a little bit better here. Dear Jim Stahl, how much money did you make last year? Okay, it's a good question, and I'm going to be honest. But you make it awfully hard for me to... See, now, that dog is upset, but I'm being honest. Listen, there's a dog barking, and I'm being honest. This is nighttime, and you're going to have dogs. I could answer this question, but it's too vague. How much money did I make gross? Did I net? Are you talking a fiscal calendar year, or just a calendar year? See, I said fiscal, and I should have said calendar. See, that's a mistake, but I'm keeping going because we're being totally honest here. Let's go to the third letter. Here we go. Dear Jim Stahl, I have two questions. First, have you ever had sex with a woman other than your wife since you've been married? And two, how much money did you gross in calendar year 1981? Okay, that's a pretty well thought out, nicely worded question. I'm going to be totally honest in answering this because I can answer a question like this. Unfortunately, we're out of time, and I can't do it. So anyway, I think I've demonstrated that Laugh Tracks is a totally honest show, and that you can believe me when I say that this show is probably the funniest comedy show in the history of television. Okay, maybe the Chuckles the Clown Dies episode on Mary Tyler Moore was funnier, but that wasn't totally honest, because Chuckles the Clown was not a real clown. He was an actor pretending to be a clown. So when that elephant stepped on his head and squashed his brains into a little grease spot, he didn't really die. I know the guy. I see him at Dan Tana's all the time. So, Jim Stahl saying, stay tuned, honestly. Want to quiet that dog, please? It's on new television here.
You have to get to the other side. Woo!
With all the news, and I'll make it fit. Scientists have discovered that reading causes cancer, which means that William F. Buckley is in big trouble, and the Reagans don't have to worry. This is Bill Sprint. I'm an audit.
Hi, do you work here?
What?
I'd like to try on some shoes. Do you work here?
Okay, this is my first day and everything. Yeah, I work. I'm in this business. Ladies' shoes. I love ladies' shoes. I mean, I don't love ladies' shoes. But sit down. I like my shoes. I like your shoes. All right, just do them. Just put your foot out. All right, what can I do for you?
I saw some shoes in the window I'd like to try on.
Oh, you don't have to. You can try them on right here, because, like, in the window, it's so hot and everything.
No.
So just right here, okay? Let me just get your sign there. Okay.
Wait a minute. No, you don't know which ones.
Customer and everything. I'm so embarrassed. I forgot to ask which ones, so I brought them all.
Yeah,
which ones did you want? Just pick one.
I was hoping
to
find the gold ones with the buckles.
Here they are. All right, just try these on and everything. I just took your leg.
That's okay.
It's part of the job. I have to do that. Okay, just take these off. All right. Here we go. There.
I
touched it. Whoa, I just saw off your dress. Is it Tuesday? Do you want to buy odor ears?
I don't believe you.
I'm sorry. I'm not supposed to smell your feet. I'm sorry. Walk.
This is way too big.
Walk. You know, it's so comfortable. Wait a minute. Wait. You know, it's Wednesday anyhow. You. First one. Again, not a customer.
This line is for people who have funnier material than Tom Dreesen.
Ready for the chorus. Curtain.
Is she really going out with him?
Well, there she is. Let's ask her.
Betty, is that Jimmy's ring you're wearing?
Mm-hmm. Gee, it must be great riding with him.
Is he picking you up after school today?
Mm-mm.
By the way, where'd you meet him?
I met him at the candy store. Turn around and smile at me, you get the picture?
Yes, we see.
That's when I fell for leader of the pack. My folks are always putting him down. They said he came from the wrong side of town. I know he was sad. That's why I fell for.
sort of small, and kissed me goodbye. The tears were beginning to show. As he drove away on that rainy night, I begged him to go slow. Whether he heard, I'll never know.
Here is a Laugh Tracks television first. 8 impressions of Sammy Davis Jr. at the same time.
He's my main man.
Ladies and gentlemen, Cool and the Gang. With a video game review in a hurry. Donkey Kong. He tosses the barrels. The little guy jumps. There is no donkey. This is Bill Sprint. I'm a free game.
Okay, we've only got 5 minutes to speech class, Vicky. You gotta think of something to talk about.
God, peer group pressure, hoya. I'm gonna go into modeling. You never have to talk then. Cheryl Teague's move over. Christy Brinkley, you're next. I'm serious. I'm gonna.
Okay, we got 4 minutes now. 4 minutes.
Hey, wait! What am I gonna talk about? I suppose I'm gonna talk about, like, oh, I know. Like, my mom's bowling team and junk. You know, like, she bowls every Wednesday night. Like, she's got these really grody shirts and junk with her name across the back. Like, she's only been bowling since the beginning of time. I could talk about that, but it's just like Fred and Wilma. Hello, Bedrock City.
Okay, that's good, though. That's really good. I mean, that's really good.
Oh, it is not. It's like the most dog topic of all time. Gainsburg is City. Lassie, roll over. Play dead. I'm the floor. Get out. I'm sorry. I can't hack it.
Well, you know something? Well, maybe if you'd done this when they handed it to you, instead of, like, becoming the human hickey of the world with Fred Baumgarten, you wouldn't be having, like, this total breakdown like Chicken Out City.
Oh, so whip me, beat me, hate me, stab me, dad. Wait! Sure, Hurt made something. Anyway, I don't even like Craig. He's, like, toad of the world of the world. And that's a bad rep. I'm getting a bad rep. What am I gonna talk about?
Okay,
Okay, how about Matt Dillon?
Oh.
Like, you've got thousands of pictures of him. You've got every teen beat that's ever been printed. No way. Like, Matt Dillon. I'm sure I'm going to talk about his favorite food or something. No way. I know what I'm going to talk about. How about if I talk about that one lake in Poland, you know? Lake Walesa, you know? And they closed it down and nobody could party there and junk.
Really? I'm sure.
It was really bummer. No, I can't talk about that. It's, like, too current topic. Everybody's going to talk about it. Okay, we've got 2 minutes. Okay, Jack City, beat the clock. Check me up another meaningless statistic. God, I can't believe you're putting the pressure on like you are. I've got to talk about something. All right, I'm going to tell her, like, I made this promise to this, like, cult leader, junk, you know, and, like, that I couldn't talk for a week. That'll be it. That'll be cool.
Okay, that's it. Okay, what are you going to talk about, Vicky?
Okay, I'm the coolest. Okay, I'm going to talk about why I want to join the Peace Corps.
Okay, that's really good.
Oh, that
really
my good. Sister already did it. It's like the coolest topic of
but
the world.
But good.
No, she already got the biggest A. I can't do that. But I'll be better. I will. It'll be cool.
Beats the heck out of me.
There's all this stuff around.
Yeah, it's really strange. Yeah.
Frank, what are you doing here?
I thought I was going to ask you the same thing. Did you get an invitation?
Yeah. What's this all about? Do you know?
I don't know.
Wait.
Can we ask Lucy?
Lucy, come here.
What's going on?
Well, beats me. All I got was this invitation.
Yeah.
Howie, did you say the same thing?
It doesn't say who it's for, though.
No, but it's all
the
same.
Yeah, this is all fine. It'll be fun. Whatever.
Surprise! It's my birthday! I've got presents for everybody! Well, at least the crew's here. We can have a really great party.
It's really incredible, but I just read where our first lady, Nancy Reagan, she's starting to increase her China collection. It's true. Yesterday, she bought the Great Wall. I'd like to see what closet she puts that in. But seriously, hey, that's another story. And I also read where 1,000 members of the Polish-American League are marching on Washington. Yeah, they're going to protest the discrimination against all Polish people. And right now, they're about 100 miles outside of Seattle, going north. But evidently, they're going to talk to Tip O'Neill. That should put them on the right path. But seriously, talk to you later.
Sit down. Look, this may not be the time or the place, but I'm going to be straight with you. I happen to think we have an open and shut case against you, my friend. And I think we have enough evidence to send you straight to the gas chamber. Or maybe worse. Unfortunately, with punks like you, a trial like this can drag on for months and cost the taxpayers millions of dollars. So I got a little bargain for you. You walk into that court and you plead guilty, and we'll reduce the charge to second-degree murder. You get off at the worst with life in prison.
No way, Mr. D.A.
Hey, with good behavior, you'll be out in 7 years.
You know how old I'll be in 7 years?
How old are you now?
Funny. You'll have to do better than that.
All right, plead guilty and we'll reduce the charge to first-degree manslaughter.
Nope.
Second degree.
Nope.
Assault with a deadly weapon.
Uh-uh.
Assault and battery.
Mm-mm.
Simple assault.
Nope.
Speeding.
Are you serious? You know what that'll do to my insurance rate?
Parking in a red zone, that's my final offer. Take it or leave it.
All right, you got a deal.
Jerk. If he'd held out, I would have let him off with a warning.
Did you hear about the new neuroses making the rounds?
No.
Yeah, it's called AZBP. That's short for agorazidorabordophobia.
What's that?
Well, it's a natural fear of open spaces containing Piazzadora billboards. You may have a little of it.
You know, I'm reading a dictionary right from the beginning, and I'm up to here.
That's really funny, because my mother just bought me a thesaurus.
Oh, yeah? Do you like it?
Like it? I love it. I relish it. I enjoy it. I cherish it. I dig it. I revel in it. I dote on it.
We have a friend who's so dumb, he thinks the pole vault is a place where they keep the pole.
That's why we're getting wasted.
Hey, astronomers just discovered a black band around Saturn. It's funny. I thought the Commodores were on tour in Europe.
Do another one.
You know something? Sex is like racquetball. You get sweaty for about 5 minutes and then you hurt yourself. Huh? Isn't it? Just like that? For me, it is. Just like, isn't that good?
Waiter! Check, please!
Amoebas, toy poodles, Hervé Villachez, size 3 shoe.
Get it. I'm not into small talk. You know, with all the plans for gun control in San Francisco, I guess I'll be seeing Ethel Merman in Annie Get Your Knife.
I just got a new dog, and I'm starting to train him, you know, and I found out that if you show him what to do, then he'll do it. Like, if I sit, he'll sit. If I roll over, he'll roll over.
Oh, that's great. What do you do if you want him to beg?
I just take him into the bedroom.
If Blossom Dairy married Tony Geary, divorced him and married Timothy Leary, divorced him and married Wallace Beery, divorced him and married Don Ho, Robert Clary, and Bullet Bob Turley, she'd be known as Blossom Dairy Geary Leary Beery Ho Clary and Turley.
Charlene Tilton, everything comes between her and her Calvins.
Who says there aren't miracles? I have a Blaupunkt stereo that hasn't been stolen yet. Yeah.
Consider this. Maybe, did anybody ever consider that the tower is straight and the rest of Pisa is leaning? Did you think about that? Think about that.
They even have a new credit card now for people who have to work like slaves to pay it off. It's called MasterCharge.
Good. Oh, damn.
Turn full rock advocate, Billy Rock!
tear the ceiling and I can see so many people who are confused. If there is anybody here tonight who is confused, say, I am. You know who you are, friends. And I use the term lightly, friends. Just before this show, I received a telephone call from a 15-year-old girl. I swear she sounded like she was 21. This was official business. She said to me, Billy, if I videotape my favorite television show, will I go to jail? That's what she said. I like to say yes. This is an illegal act, friends. Not since do not remove this tag under penalty of law has there been such a nuisance, a bothersome law. Everybody here today see handicap parking only. What do you think I said? See handicap parking only? I said say handicap parking only. I know you people are cheaters. You pull into the 7-Eleven and you take that first spot. You don't even look down to see the little guy sitting in the wheelchair. Friends, one day, I'm telling you people here today, one day you're going to get yours. I have people telling me all the time, oh, Billy, you look so funny. I watch you, I tape your show, and then I speed forward, and then I freeze you. Big joke, friends. One day you're going to be taping your favorite show, and the police are going to break down your door. They're going to grab you and throw you in the slammer. Everybody say Adam 12. And then you will be in the big house up the river where you will be the victim of a homosexually inspired attack. Oh, yes, you will. And then your day will be wrecked and your life will be ruined, all because you taped Joni Loves Chachi. Everybody say rerun. So, friends, you're confused, you're embittered, your life is ruined. What do you do? Do you do drugs?
Yeah.
No! You don't do drugs. And you don't park in the handicap zone either, friends. You do rock and roll. Everybody's got a good Dolby cassette tape recorder. Take your favorite albums off the radio. Save those big bucks for fun going to see movies like E.T. Hurry up, though, before they make that against the law. This is Billy Rock saying goodbye. I'm out of here before I get arrested. Good night and rock and roll.
Well, he told me that I just...
Lucy Gale, I'm so glad that you made it.
Hi.
Hi, Jill.
What's the big mystery about?
Yeah, why couldn't you just tell us over the phone? What's going on?
Okay, I'm
going
to level with you. It's my brother, Eddie. He just got out of the hospital, and I thought it'd be good for him to meet some people.
Oh, that's okay. Well, but he doesn't have some weird disease or something.
No. It's just a mental thing. He's catatonic. I know you're going to love him. Let me bring him in here.
Is this the younger
Eddie?
I don't know who he is. I'm curious.
Eddie, yeah. Here's the girls I was telling you about. Girls?
This is my brother, Eddie. He's been dying to meet you. Hi, Lucy. Thank you to meet Eddie.
Nice to meet you.
And Gail.
Hi.
My brother, Eddie.
Eddie. Nice.
Yeah.
How do you like L.A.?
Oh, he's just nuts about it. He can't wait to go to Disneyland, right, Ed? We have a lot of fun together.
Jim, I cannot believe this. I forgot I have to birth a baby this afternoon.
Oh, Lucy, don't go. Lucy, can't you see? He's crazy about you. Look, he's winking.
Yeah, and he's cute, Jim, but I've made a commitment, and I
know,
really must...
Listen, I gotta get going, too, because we both got some tweezing to do this afternoon.
Right.
Wait a second, wait a second.
I have heavy tweezing. Maybe.
We'll catch on the back.
I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Stay.
Girl?
You look like you could use a drink. I know I sure as heck could. What are you drinking? Don't tell me. I can tell by looking at you, a zombie, right? Bartender, two zombies, one for me, one for my pal. Life is tough, huh? Can you keep a secret? I mean, don't say word one. Keep something under your hat. I'm running away from home. Running away, making a clean break. No more problems, no more responsibilities. You know what I'm saying? Thank you. You know when I made the big decision? This morning, looking in the bathroom mirror, I said to myself, hey, I'm not living, you know? I'm just going through the motions. I don't even feel anything. I don't feel any pain, no pleasure, no love, not even hate. Is this any way to live? No, just like I was a stone. I don't know why I'm telling you all these problems. You have no way of understanding the way I feel, but thanks for trying anyway. You got some problems you want to talk about, huh? What's wrong? Problem at home? Your wife? Is she frigid? Tell me about it. My wife is so cold that when she aerobicizes, she doesn't sweat, she defrosts.
No, well, Fred, it's nice seeing you here. What a surprise.
Long time no see.
Hey, I see you met my brother, Eddie.
Yeah, I kind of like him. He's a very good listener. But you know, can I tell you something about him? He's kind of cheap. He hasn't even offered to buy me a drink.
Oh, Fred, I guess I should tell you, he's catatonic.
Listen, Jim, what your brother does in the privacy of his own bedroom is no matter of mine, okay? Listen, let's have one for the road, shall we?
Oh, a great idea.
Drink up. Here's mud in your eye.
Madam, we don't ordinarily serve wheat thins with breakfast. And if you're going to use that kind of language, you can just check out, Miss Duncan. Hotel Hollywood, I'm sorry you're upset, Mr. Smith. We at Hotel Hollywood aim to please. If you're threatening suicide, may we move you to a higher floor? Hello?
Welcome to Hotel Hollywood.
I'll take a single room, please.
Regular or deluxe?
What's the difference?
The deluxe has cheese.
I'll take it. Hold the pickles.
No, I like to get really, really drunk. That way everybody else seems to stand still.
Sir, please keep your voice down. We've got bums trying to sleep in the lobby.
Okay. You know, I like to get really, really drunk. That way everybody else seems to stand still. Is that low enough?
Careful, you could put an eye out.
Wow, 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 wow. Wow, 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 wow.
I was at the dentist's office this afternoon.
More sailors have been through her apartment than the Panama Canal. Hello, Mr. Rooney. May I help you?
Did you ever notice that when you walk up to a hotel clerk, they always ask you if they can help you? Well, if I needed help, I'd do it myself. That's why I like signs. They're simple and to the point. Things like do not disturb or make up the room or no shoes, no shirt, no service. I like that.
There are autographs today. I'm preparing for a co-starring role in my next Joan Crawford picture. Well, perhaps one autograph won't tire me. You have a quill? Of course! I would love to sign an autograph for an adoring, devoted fan. Pen will do. How do you spell little people? How do you spell grand dame? No one must see me.
How do you spell has been?
She's been around so long, she has Moses' name in her autograph book.
You know, I used to be a choreographer.
for Joe Cocker. He was so beautiful to me. Can you see?
Even as a little girl, I wanted to act very badly.
And you succeeded.
Of course I did. Fabulous.
There are two things I will not tolerate in a soldier. Cowardice and high heels.
One thing. Fortunately, it's the same thing I'm interested in.
I wonder if that's where the expression over 2 million served came from.
You know, every Wednesday, my doctor plays golf. You know what Jack Nicklaus does on Wednesday? He plays doctor.
I just came down a flight of stairs. Why do they call them a flight? They don't fly. Maybe when you fall down, then you fly. I don't know. That bothers me.
Nice guys always finish last.
Nice guys don't finish.
Gotta get the game.
Hey, wait up, I'll come with you.
Okay.
I hate cowards. I remember a soldier once came up to me crying like a baby. He said, "I'm sorry, General, but I just can't take another man's life." Well, I pointed my pistol at his head and I said, "Son, you want to die a soldier or a coward?" Well, to make a long story short, he decided to become a soldier. Shortly afterwards, was shot and killed in battle. But in his dying breath, he said to me, and I'll never forget this, he said, "General, thank you." At least it sounded like thank you.
Laugh Tracks was brought to you by Ultra Band Deodorant. New Ultra Band protects against wetness in an ultra dry formula.
How you gonna do it if you really don't wanna dance? By standing on the wall.
Get your back up off the wall.
Tell me. How you gonna do it if you really don't wanna dance? By standing on the wall.
Get your back up off the wall.
I heard all the people saying,
get down on it.
Come on and
get down on it.
If you really want it,
get down on it.
You gotta feel it.
Get down on it.
Come on in,
get down on it,
baby, baby,
get down on it,
get on it,
get down on it.
I say, people,
what
you gonna do? You gotta get on the groove. If you want your body to move, tell me, baby, how you gonna do it if you really don't wanna dance? By standing on the wall,
get your back up off the wall.
Tell me, how you gonna do it if you really won't take a chance? By standing on the wall,
get your back up off the wall.
Cause I heard all the people saying,
get down on it, get down on it, get down on it, get down on it, get down on it. Get down on it.
When you're dancing,
get down on it.
Baby,
get down on it,
get on it,
get down on it.
Oh, what you gonna
also
do?
Appearing in tonight's show was Jim Fisher.
Oh, what you gonna do?
Get your back up off the wall. Dance, come on. Get your back up off the wall. Dance, come on. Get down on it.
Come on in.
Get down on
if
it.
If you really want it.
Get down on it.
You gotta feel it.
Get down on
get
it.
Down on it.
Get down on it.
Come
come on and
get down on it.
Get down on it
while you're dancing.
Get down on it.
Get down on it.
Get down on it.
Get down on it.
We now return you to the Miss Nude America show, already in progress.
Well, that's it. The first Miss Nude America pageant. Have you ever seen girls like that?
Wasn't it fabulous and exciting? Well, okay, let's look at all those contestants one more time.